Hey, what's up guys, Swiss Maverick here with a quick add-on introduction in Arma 3. Grand Q ported over the M1151 Humvee from Arma 2 to Arma 3. It is a standalone add-on, meaning it's not like all in Arma or something like that, it's just this vehicle itself. But it is a port over, you can see that based on the textures, it does look like in Arma 2, it's not like high quality or basically not the same quality as Arma 3 vehicles are. But nevertheless, it's still a nice looking transport vehicle with a 50 cal machine gun on top. I like to play with it a lot in Arma 2, and maybe we will even use that with the 161st Vsor. That's something I'm going to discuss with my officers first though. It is obviously possible to enter the vehicle. You got a driver seat, three back seats, as well as a gunner position, which is standing here in the center looking out of the turret. Turret is 360 degrees turnable with a M2 50 cal machine gun on top. Makes it a bit more interesting for the gunner, I'd say, because you're totally exposed to to any fire. It's not as in the Hunter where you have a remote controlled turret. So this might add a little bit of tension when you're in the gunner seat. I do like that. The turret is turnable. You got the normal 3D view as well as a side view, and zeroing on the gun is also available. So all in all the necessary functions are available and working. Let's see how it performs on the streets and also off-road. I gotta say, the driving physics is what would surprise me the most about this port over, because it seems to be really good, or surprisingly good. You can really see the suspensions and the wheels, and also how the whole thing is shaking and wobbling when you go into turns, so you can even drift a little bit. Also, the braking physics are pretty accurate, and I'd say even more realistic than with the vanilla Arma 3 vehicles. Sometimes the front wheels will totally block, and you will even slide a little bit. So it's definitely a lot of fun to drive this vehicle on roads as well as off roads. Once you've installed the add-on, you can find it in the editor. It's possible to place it empty. You find it on the cars and then M1151 NATO. You can also find it in the NATO faction. There it will be spawned, occupied with AI, or if you want to take a slot, you can do that as with any other vanilla vehicle. As you see here, the editor icon is not changed, it's the standard Hunter one. But by placing the cursor over it, you can separate it from the vanilla Hunter. Let's fire a few rounds. You can get in the gunner seat, open turret here again. It's kind of it's more intense than in the Hunter, I'd say, because your head is sticking out, you can be shot by anything. That makes it a bit more interesting. If you wonder about the intense sound of the 50 cal, that's because I use the JSRS sound mode right here. I like it a lot. It adds a lot more punch to weapon sounds, and therefore adds to the immersion of the game, I'd say. So lighting up some targets, the 50 cal is pretty effective. By default, the Humvee spawns with two ammo boxes of 200 rounds each, makes 400 in total. It's not too much, so you have to basically fire accurately if you want them to last a while. But they're 50 cal rounds, so they're very effective against infantry, transport vehicles, or even helicopters. Alright, I'm through with this introduction of the standalone Humvee port over for Arma 3. I do like it a lot, and I think it's cool that it is a standalone port over, so it's not a huge add-on with a lot of additional vehicles and whatnot. It's just that Humvee is a standalone. So if you like to play with Humvees in Arma 2 or even Arma 1, this is definitely the add-on for you. As always, thanks a lot for watching. I'm Swiss Maverick, and I catch you soon.